evening and welcome. We are rounding out our March, or our Music in Our Schools month with our concert, our band ensembles this evening. We are certainly looking forward to that. There's been a lot of celebrations in our school and right up here on our stage to celebrate Music in Our Schools month. We started with our musical. We've had our junior high and elementary schools here, and we are pleased to be rounding out with our band ensembles. I want to take an opportunity and thank Mr. Cavanis for all that he does for our programs and our students, and I want to take an opportunity to thank you, all of our GRB families, for supporting us and your kids and our programs. They sounded great from our hallways. They're excited to be performing this evening. We'll do this again in the spring, so this isn't it for the year, but great time of the year as we begin the season of spring to celebrate the sounds of music. So without further ado, I am pleased to introduce Mr. Cavanis with our concert band.
Bear with me, you're not going to see the normal cues or the I did think about buying the tuxedo shirt to go along with them, but I didn't. That first piece of accolades, nice opener. I hope that you can hear how much improvements happened since the beginning of the year. Okay, it's really, really done a terrific job. And the next piece is really going to show that off. Ruminations is a piece by Sean O'Loughlin, who is the resident pops conductor for the Syracuse Symphony Orchestra and out for the Vancouver Symphony Orchestra. He's a kid from Solvay, you know, just a normal kid, a second man, just like these guys. He played basketball. We played in basketball leagues when I was younger, and I played center, by the way. And that was a joke. So he's one of us. Okay, the reason I like to play his music and introduce him is a lot of times I can get him to stop in, and I told you guys that he's good enough, I can have him come up when he's in town doing it. But it goes to show them that it doesn't matter where you're from, if you try hard enough and you really work hard, you can be successful at the highest levels. And so I hope you enjoy this piece. We learned a lot with this because slow pieces aren't done well by young groups. It really takes a lot of work and effort, and these guys have not only come a long way, they're really, really playing this piece well. So I hope you enjoy Ruminations.
Thank you.
before we perform the Celtic Air and Dance. There is a New York City field trip that's going out. We have 50 people signed up, well, actually 57 people signed up for 50 slots. We will get a second bus if we have more people coming in. So, you know, if you decide that parents or anybody else wants to go or wants to, maybe now to try and fill that second bus, we can do that. But I just have to make sure that we can get the second bus, so I will do that coming up tomorrow with the travel agent. There is another fundraiser out, the last fundraiser, the Kathy Cakes fundraiser, which will be in for the Easter holiday. So you can get those and pick them up, and they'll be there for the holiday time. I believe the last thing is there are a couple of events coming up. The April 7th concert is with the Central Winds Jazz Orchestra. That's jazz ensembles, the Phoenix High School Jazz Ensemble, the Fulton High School Jazz Ensemble, and the Central Winds Jazz Ensemble will perform together. There'll be a bunch of clinics in the afternoon. I'll have the exact times up for you probably beginning next week. There's also the Brass Bash, which we're going to go to in at West Hill High School, and that will be April 4th. There's also a jazz concert here April 21st, which our jazz ensembles will also participate in. If you haven't noticed, since everything released, we're going full bore. So there's a bunch of concerts coming up. We hope that you'll come to them and support the students and support the professionals that are coming in to the area. I'll try and get some PR out on that now that we're absolutely confirmed on those concerts. Just remember, this year they are going forward with Memorial Day Parade. I meant to check this before tonight. It's usually on Saturday. I think they kept it on Saturday. Does anybody know? Okay. It's usually on Saturday here. So if at all possible, we have just enough to fill up two bands, which would be a great marching band. So if we might be able to plan our trip about so that these guys can participate in the Memorial Day Parade, especially now with the climate and things as they are in the world, it's really nice to help support our community. And to have the kids there for that parade. It is something special in Fulton, and especially now with our climate, I think it's really important for them to be there. So I appreciate the help with that. Other than that, Celtic Air and Dance, last song, and we will have these guys file up that section, and then Wind Ensemble will file up, and we'll continue right on with the concert. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
We actually practiced them standing, and they blew it. Hopefully the music sounds better. The first piece is a suite in E-flat. First suite in E-flat by Gustav Holst. This is written for English military band in the mid-1800s. But it's still, late 1800s. It's still played pretty much every two or three years in band. Either this or the suite in F or English folk song suite. It's one of those stylistic pieces. It's just a giant band literature that every kid should play. I haven't done this in several years because it depends on instrumentation. It is in three movements, so normally we perform three movements without applause between. So I just ask that you hold the applause to the end of the movements, and I hope you enjoy Sweet E Flat.
Thank you.
here. It's from Wonder Woman, 84. This is one of those pieces. It's, you know, having been such a weird year. I picked that piece in September, August of this year. And it's a 7/8 piece. It goes da 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 da. Stays the same way the whole time. My idea was I was going to teach the kids with a pop tune 7/8 time. Because I don't know where they are. I don't know what's going on. So things progress throughout the year. Okay, now we're playing Sweet E flat, which normally I would not play. I wouldn't think that I was going to be able to get to that with these guys. Okay, so we're playing D mascara, and we come out, and you know they're starting to get a little bit more comfortable. And they go, "Mr. Kiyomis, this piece isn't very good." And I go, "You're right. You found that out." Because it's just very repetitive. It's repetitive. I was going to use it as a teaching tool, and it's a somewhat interesting piece. And we were trying to do dynamics so it makes it more interesting for you guys. But I thought it was great that they'd gotten to the point where they could tell. And I said, once you play the music well, it's okay to have an opinion to say, "I don't like this." We're going to perform it so the audience doesn't know that, and they can love it if they want to. But the fact is I'm enjoying the fact that they got to that point that they were able to do that. So it's a testament on their part that they're practicing, they're working, and I'm going to push them to the end of the year to be great. Okay? And that's one of the reasons why we ended up doing Sweet E flat, and the three Celtic dances is another one that I actually programmed, but in my mind I thought this is going to be a good end of the year piece. And I put it out thinking, let me see where they are. And so we're ended up playing it 3 or 4 months ahead of where I thought we were going to be. Which is great. So, before we get to three Celtic dances, we've got the percussion ensemble that's going to play it's a movement from a piece, River Dance, which I did probably 15 or 16 years ago when the Irish dancing tours were coming through. They did this piece, and one of the movements was a percussion ensemble. It's supposed to be reminiscent of the tapping sounds that you get when you're dancing in Irish dance. So we hope that you enjoy three of our percussionists performing Thunder and Lightning for River Dance.